We're gonna sign a little bit of front wheel. This is what I'm using. I have it for years. It's amazing. All right. So what I do is usually, and use one new cloth to apply the cream. And then I wait 10-15 minutes, and then I use another one to wax it. All right. But now I have to re-grease the bearings. So I took the bolts out. And let's take this one out. Yeah, that happened. I'm put it here for now. Clean that up this little bit. And let's get something. The old grease, it doesn't look too bad, but I'm gonna replace it. And these bearings, I think this is the second time I replace it. These bearings are new. I have replaced them, well, 3 or 4 years ago. The bike doesn't have too many miles on these bearings. I'm gonna put a little bit W40 here to clean it, but now I have the paste, the aluminum paste here. So let me start cleaning this. I'm gonna start from the valve down, but I wanna be able to get a little bit out of this grease. A little more, okay. Let's go. This technique, it works a little bit slow. You can get it done on a wheel like that in once. You can probably get it done on chrome. Not once, but not on a, on an aluminum wheel. I have done once the other side once, but I'm gonna do it two more times each side. Taking the bedding inside. All right, it's in there. No movement. We're all good. And I'm gonna check the other one too. The other side. Okay. If you're ordering, this is the Michelin Commander 139D B16. I like this tire a lot. And on the rear I have a Metzeler, because I have to replace it separately. Okay. I'm cleaning the bearing from the old grease. The spacer. Okay, it's still good. It has some scratches on from, I know from who. That's the guy who replaced the tire. So you gotta be careful who you go to replace your tire. And that's from, it's not simple. It's like 2-3 replacements. I should replace this gasket, but it's still holding. But I might just, you know, order a new one. It's not really a big deal. Spacer. Okay, and the bolts. Okay. All right, we're getting there. Yes, it's a total restoration. I think I'm like 95%. I'm getting there. Okay, I'm getting ready to put it back. So I'm gonna start with this side. Okay, I'm cleaning the main bushing also. And I have a SKF bearing grease, medium heat. This is very good grease. So I got my flashlight so I can see what's going on in here. The bushing goes all the way to the other side. All right, so let's put first. Let me see if I can have to clean a little more here. Okay. Let's put grease on there. I'm gonna put grease on the bushing first. And when I put it back, I'm gonna put, of course, grease on the axle. The bushing is up in the air. That means, like, you know, you only need to do the two sides of it. Maybe a little bit inside. Yes, you have to get dirty with it for that. And I'm going to put some grease inside here on the bearing. If you put a little bit too much, you know, or a little bit less, it doesn't really matter. It's just grease. It's just going to spread around. The black side is up of that spacer, and this goes here. All right, before I do that, you know what? Or put the spacer inside that. Right there. And I will grease the spacer a little bit, because it has some kind of friction here. Yeah, that's good. Then the axle is going to have grease right here. It will be a little bit more. But right now we're good. Okay, I'm going to put just temporary two bolts to hold it in place. No. I try not to get anything like grease or stuff on the tire, as you can see. All right, one here. Alright guys, I have a little problem here. I want to put the two tomato plants here. Look what's going on. Because he ate them all last year, so I have only two. And I have to put the guard, the mesh wire, so I will protect them. Okay? But this is Harley, that's Harley. A relaxing place right here, so she got pissed. She doesn't let me dig. All right, let's see what's gonna happen. Can you get off there? Can you get off there? I need to dig. She bites me. What are you doing here? What do you want? I don't need a lawyer. Yes. This is... Halle. Look. She's a pissed. This is mine. I'm gonna put it. All right. Halle. Ella, come on. No, no, you have to go. I have to put the mesh wire. Sit over there. Look at that. Yes. No, not good. Stop it.
I'm very excited today. I got the message from my body in the body shop. My stuff are ready. So I'm going to pick it up. Check it out. Oh boy. Okay, so let's go.
Okay, so we are here. Talk at the YouTube. Say hi. Say hello. This is the professor. Let's check it out.
Oh, man. Check this out. Oh.
All right, we're gonna pick them up and go home, straight home. I'm not stopping nowhere. His Rod King. Looks like new. Sidecar. Come on, let me take a picture of you. Oh yeah, looking good.
Literally out loose. We'll be right back.
men's cave. And check it out. This is the rear fender. Never looks so good. This is just dust. Look at that. Unbelievable. Brand new. And look at him. Let's see. Here. Check it out. This is just my sweat. It's very hot and humid today. But this is the front fender. Okay, I'm gonna put some pictures to see how was it before. You have a couple of scratches there, and you have a couple of scratches here. And we're not gonna even talk about the gas tank. I mean, this is how it came up from the factory. Check it out. Bye. All right, let's get to work. I also put a little bit W4 in here and wipe it so we'll maintain anti-rust protection. I put the bolts here temporary and I'm going to take them off again. I just want to lay out the whole system right now. I'm going to take them off again and put Loctite. We're still good here, it's about 35 degrees outside. Yes. It's hot. Okay, that's good enough. I'm gonna check now the electrical and I come back. Actually, I'm alone. I'm gonna try not to scratch it. What I do is working. I put a shrink heat here on this long one because I need them for the side bags to reduce vibration. I don't know if it's gonna fit. Let's see now. Okay, I put a washer here too to reduce a little bit the vibration because I have to put a spacer here. The bag goes right here, vertical with that strut. If you look at thing episode 1 or 2 of the, when I start the bike, I put the bags first because I was not sure I'm gonna go to a total restoration of this thing. Unbelievable. All right, so let me get ready the right side blinker. Okay, that's this one. Now the problem is here goes everything, goes also the CC bar that I have already right there, nice and clean. Let me put temporary a bolt here. I have a little problem with these bolts. I check for replacement, they don't have it, so I have to restore the originals. You know, what are you gonna do? And okay, I'll be back. a little bit, you know, for the paint, mostly, like, a little bit like a brushing or something. Let me get this. Have to pick up the fender a little bit. I'm trying not to forget something, you know, it's been a while. So there's support here for the cable, right? What I'm doing right now, I'm going to show you. Right here, see that? And on the other side too. So we're all good. I should have put the connectors later, but it fit. I'm talking about the nut. All right. Let's see if we can put a couple of thumbs here. Yes. All right, so this is the short one, goes here. All right. Let's do it now. If I finish the rear today, I'll be very happy. I'll be very happy. All right, this is the cable. Have external power. I'm going to see what I'm going to do with that later, in a later time. And should have the cable here for the LEDs. These are LEDs, believe me, in the night time, they work really good. So I have like three red lights here. I have these, I have replaced it to a LED, this bulb. Okay, so I have like 1, 2, 3 LEDs. For a softer, it's okay, I have to be a little bit visible. I might put a strobe light, just for a case of emergency too, but we'll see. All right, so now it's time for that. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna do a little test. Okay, so I have cruising lights. Right blinker is not gonna blink now because I already have ground on the front. Okay. And the problem I have now is I have also the stoplight on. This is the stoplight, and I have no idea why. Turn on. I'm trying to find the sensor. Maybe the problem is here. I gotta take it out and see, but there is no brake fluid anywhere. Everything is empty. This too. You know, I don't know. Yeah, it's on. And I don't know why. What are you doing? You're guilty. I know you're guilty. I know you're guilty. And that's Harley there, and the problem is he doesn't live here alone. That's the problem. You're very guilty. Yes, you're very guilty. Live here alone. Yes. All right, so yes, we're getting there. So I have put the rear fender
Okay, these long bolts is because I have the new leather bags modified, the Hepco Becker, on episode 2. And this I haven't finished. I'm going to take it out again, fix a little bit of wires. So I take my time. The rear is important. All right, let's see. Okay, look how nice it already looks. Okay, unfortunately, where I am, they don't have the small, beautiful plates we have in the States. They have like this big. I'm not gonna say it. So actually, I have to put my plate here, okay? But you know what? I'm waiting for the light to dry because I put some silicone on this part here, so I will give it like an hour before I put it on. And probably, if everything goes well, I'm gonna start tensioning things. And tomorrow, the day after, I'm gonna put the rear wheel on. Okay. No rush. All right. This is what's going on when I eat a sandwich. Look at that. Bullying big time. All of them. Bye. Okay. Let's see if I can put it from here. No. Go very slow so I don't scratch it. It's just not easy. Maybe I can put one bolt here. Temporary one bolt like this. Okay. I know I don't have too much space right here, but I don't want to be moving the bike. Okay. I'm just going to put them temporary, and tomorrow or whatever I start again, I'm gonna take them off now the fender is on, and put the spring. There's a little wire here that holds the front brake caliper cable, and I'm gonna cover the fender so I won't scratch it. Okay. It's still looking like a little bike again, a little bit. All right. Problem. The problem is was the front switch. Look. Okay. It's inside here. It's very sensitive. So nothing is assembled here. You see, it's everything is loose. So, but
I found the problem. And flashlight working. Of course, no, they're not gonna blink now because they're not grounded. But that's fine. All right, so. Okay. And if you have an Evo and you wanna put a light, a LED like this, go ahead, it's much brighter than the regular bulbs we have. All right. Let me test these LEDs too. And I'm gonna call it a day.